I remember one evening when I was 16 years old, I was standing in our kitchen where my mom and my sister were fixing dinner. My dad was watching Monday Night Football. And then a guy that I'd let in our house because he said he needed help walked up and pointed a pistol in my face and he said, "You know what it's all about." I remember slowly backing away, thinking to myself, this always happens to the other guy. This doesn't happen to me. Over the next several hours, he and his accomplice hogtied my family, hands and feet behind our back on the living room floor. They took turns sexually assaulting my then 12-year-old sister, sat down and ate the dinner that my mom had fixed, and then shot us all in the back and left us for dead. My mom and dad both died right there in front of me. Leslie and I were able to get loose from our ropes and drive to medical help. A few weeks later, they caught the guys that did this, and that started our journey in the criminal justice system that lasted more than 17 years and in which Leslie and I testified against these guys 9 different times. And the biggest thing that I learned from that whole experience was that they had their rights and we as the victims had none. In fact, I learned that in the U.S. Constitution, there are 23 enumerated rights for the protection of the accused. And that was passed as part of the original Bill of Rights. It was in response to the oppression by the British government over the American colonists. And so it's a good thing. I'm all for every single one of them, and I want them there if I'm ever accused of a crime. But I also learned that there are 0 rights for the victim in the Constitution. I've been a lawyer now for more than 25 years. I was a state senator in Oklahoma for 12 years in which I passed more than 20 pieces of legislation that were signed into law to provide for rights for crime victims, but also to try to improve our criminal justice system and sentencing and prison reform. And I can tell you that as of today, that if you're the victim of a crime, you are not nearly as protected as you probably think you are. Over 20% of Americans are directly affected by crime every year, and so odds are, at some point in your lifetime, you are going to be the victim of a crime. With these videos, I talk about the different rights that you have as a crime victim, but I also talk about some of the ways that we can improve our criminal justice system and make it more fair, not just for the victims, but for the accused and those that have already been convicted of a crime. My name is Brooks Douglas. Thank you for watching.